There are thousands of active cults all over the world. The number of cult members nationally is said to be around 300,000 to 3 million. Today, we are going to be looking at some of the strangest doomsday cults in history. From the Heaven's Gate cult to the Order of the Solar Temple. Let's talk about this and more only in today's video. Starting off this countdown, we have Heaven's Gate. Founded in 1974 and led by Bonnie Nettles and Marshall Applewhite, the Heaven's Gate cult believed in UFOs and impending doom. They convinced their followers that the only way they could escape this was by taking their own lives. By doing this, they believed that they would reach the next level and help evolution on other planets. And according to them, Jesus was an extraterrestrial, and when he died, his body rose from the dead before being carried away by a spaceship. Interesting, I know. In 1997, 39 members took their lives, and they were all found wearing arm patches that read, "Heaven's Gate Away Team." Moving on at number 9, we have the Church Universal and Triumphant. The Church Universal and Triumphant was founded in 1975. It was run by a woman named Elizabeth Clare Prophet. She made her followers believe that she was a channel for God. Apparently, God told her that the world was going to end. So she moved her church compound near Yellowstone National Park for safety reasons. She said that the end of the world would come in 1990 after a nuclear war between the US and Russia. When that didn't happen, a lot of members left the cult. Slowly over time, the cult just dissolved. In our 8th spot, we have William Miller. William Miller was an American Baptist preacher as well as the founder of Adventism. He was known for preaching about the end of the world, which he prophesied would be in 1844. He thought the end would come as a purifying apocalypse, so the world would be cleansed of sinners. Miller and his followers, the Millerites, believed that there would be a fire in which saints would be resurrected and they would cleanse the world of this evil. When this didn't happen, he lost his loyal followers. In fact, the day in which the world didn't end is now referred to as the Great Disappointment. In our 7th spot, we have Jim Jones. Jim Jones is known as one of the most famous cult leaders in the world. He was the founder and leader of the People's Temple, which he ran in an isolated area in the Guyanese jungle. He convinced his followers that the government was coming for him and that they were going to start a thermonuclear war. In fact, he believed that on July 15th, 1967, a nuclear attack was going to happen. Alas, it didn't. Anyways, in 1978, he convinced his followers to take their lives. He described this to be a revolutionary act. So on November 18th, his cult leaders drank cyanide-laced punch. Some of them drank it willingly, while others had it forced upon them. In the end, 909 people lost their lives. It was said to be one of the most harrowing tragedies in American history. Coming in at number 6, we have the Branch Davidians. This cult was originally founded in 1929 by a man named Victor T. Hotez. And they were a spin-off of the Seventh-day Adventists. Then in 1955, Ben Rhoden organized the Branch Davidians. Later, the cult was controlled by David Koresh. He believed that the end was near. He believed in the several seals from the Bible's Book of Revelation. He believed that when the seals were opened, that marked the second coming of Christ and the start of the apocalypse. So David and his cult were preparing for the apocalypse. He claimed that he could speak to God, and that's what God told him to do, to prepare. But things ended badly in 1993 when the FBI and military stormed the cult's base. They had belief that the group was stockpiling illegal weapons, so they conducted a raid. This led to a deadly shootout and ended with their building going up in flames. This resulted in the death of 76 cult members. We're now at our 5th and halfway mark with the Russian Doomsday Cult. The Russian Doomsday Cult was founded by a man named Pyotr Kuznetsov. He believed that the end of the world was going to happen in 2008. So in 2007, he gathered the 30 members of his group and sent them to a shelter in a cave. He instructed them to wait there until the end of the world. Of course, Pyotr didn't accompany them. After 6 months in the cave, 14 members decided to come out. Sadly, 2 passed away in this cave. 9 members decided to stay a bit longer, but then later came out. In fact, the members were instructed to take their own lives if the authorities tried to intervene. Thankfully, when the police did come to their rescue, they didn't do that. As for Piotr, well, he tried to take his own life when his doomsday prediction didn't come true. He then was sent to a psychiatric facility. In our fourth spot, we have the family. Otherwise known as the Great White Brotherhood, this was an Australian New Age group led by a woman named Anne Hamilton. She convinced her followers that she was the reincarnation of Jesus. She also said that Buddha and Krishna were other spiritual beings that came down to help humanity. And of course, they all believed that the end was near. The cult lived away together in the countryside outside of Melbourne. The kids were instructed to never talk to outside people. They were all homeschooled. Those that didn't listen were punished through beatings, starvation, or emotional torture. People there were also frequently drugged with hallucinogenics. In the end, the police raided the cult and saved the 28 children that they had brought in. Anne and the other woman helping her were then criminally charged. And a number of cult members actually sued her for psychiatric and psychological illness, upon other things. It said that she paid hundreds of thousands of dollars to her victims. Moving on to number three, we have Box Canyon Cult. Located in Southern California, Box Canyon was the perfect rocky hideaway for a doomsday cult. It all started when a man who went by the name of Krishna Venta claimed that he was the second coming of Christ and was over 240,000 years old. In 1948, he bought 25 acres of land in Box Canyon to build a monastery and several rooms for his followers to stay in. In the monastery, Venta would preach about the impending World War III, which would spark the end of the world. He said that World War III was their chance to take back the world, but they were never able to see their plan through. In 1958, two men whose wives joined the cult decided to bomb it. The blast killed them, Venta, and seven of the followers. Some of the survivors stayed there, whereas others went to join Jim Jones's cult and later passed away there. In our second spot, we have the Order of the Solar Temple. This cult was formed in 1984 by Joseph DiMambro and Luke Jouret. It started off its teachings based on New Age spiritualism, but they realized that they got more followers when they started to become more doomsday focused. And then these followers brought them more money, so they obviously loved that. So they believed that once the end of the world came, they would be transported to another planet and then live there. Now the history of what went down in this cult is very complex, so I'm just gonna do a quick rundown. In the 1990s, authorities started to investigate this group. In 1994, a man and his family were killed after speaking out about the cult. Days later, two temple buildings in Switzerland burnt to the ground. 48 bodies were found inside. Some were shot, others were injected with tranquilizers and left to perish in the fire. Then in 1995, a building in the Swiss Alps burnt down. 16 bodies were found inside there. Then in 1997, a building in Quebec burnt down. 5 more members died then. In total, 74 cult members passed away. To this day though, this cult still exists. And in our number one spot today, we have the Shinriko cult. The Shinriko cult was founded in 1984 by a man named Shoko Ashihara. Members of this cult believed that the end of the world was near. The leader predicted that it would occur in 1996 or between 1999 and 2003, but he claimed that the members were going to be the only ones that survived. But in order to become a member, they would have to sign their estates over to the group, which in the end made him incredibly wealthy. In 1995, the cult carried out the deadly Tokyo subway sarin attack, where 13 people died and thousands got injured. Apparently, this was done as an attempt to start the apocalypse, but also to show how strong they were to try and stop the authorities from shutting down their cult. As a result of this attack, 13 members of the group got the death sentence, including the leader. After his death, the name of the cult changed, and to this day, it's still active. It's said that it has about 1,500 active followers. Alright guys, that's all for today's video. Let's move quickly along to our comment shoutout portion. I'll be shouting out comments from the video, Top 10 Alien Sightings Leaked by Government Officials. Abigail commented, Lindsay, I hope you choose my comment on your next shoutout. Well, I did, there you go. And Abigail continued on saying, I definitely believe in aliens. There's no way with how vast the universe is that we are the only planet with life. There's def more out there. Honestly, I agree, but they probably don't look like, you know, the creatures that we have made them out to be. You know, the whole we come in peace. I don't know. Jose Lucero commented, what about the man from Alaska that got the transmitter took out of his leg? I don't know the story, but now I have to research it. Wow, okay. And Rats and Rats commented, is she a government worker? Government? Why did I say it like that? But yeah, I am. Anyways, alright guys, that's all the comments I'm shouting out for today's video. Make sure to comment something down below for a chance to be featured in my next comment shout out. And as always, don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe to Most Amazing Top 10 for more amazing videos. I've been your host, Lindsay Ivan, and I'll see ya when I see ya. Alright guys, that's all for today's video. I apologize if I said any of these names wrong.